So let us take up the connection-oriented services of HTTP. Any connection-oriented service or any connection-oriented protocol has basically three stages to develop a connection, okay, or to throughout the life cycle of connection. There are three ways. There are three stages. First is connection has to be created. Okay, so connection establishment. Then sending data. And the third is release. So here also, in a connection-oriented service, there are three stages, the three phases. The first one is establishment of the entire path. So during the establishment of connection, HTTP sends a message to establish the connection with the endpoint, and on the way, all the HTTP layers, all the network elements that have HTTP capability, when they come across, they assign a particular reference number, a particular routing information in their network, so that the same path is chosen for subsequent messages which are coming on that particular session. Okay, so this establishment is as good as establishing a session, or you can call it establishing a virtual call, okay, a virtual circuit. So you can establish, you can think of it like a dedicated physical network has been established between all the network elements. Okay, so once the session has been established, once the virtual call has been established, all the data will go very fast because there is very less amount of routing lookup that is to be done. Okay, and after this has been established, in the phase 2, the actual message will be sent from the origin to the destination, and this delivery is quite efficient because of very less routing to be done. And in the phase 3, when all the messages are over, any of the node can begin to tear down the virtual connection. Okay, so that's the three primitives of connection oriented service. In the HTTP, this request for creating connection is called CR. Okay, as the name suggests, this is called connection request. So this message is basically sent from the origin, and on the way, all the HTTP layers, all the network elements that are HTTP capable, they go on receiving this connection request and sending it to further nodes. In this way, they just build the virtual circuit throughout the network. Okay, and when the destination accepts the CR, it sends the connection confirm message. That's called CC. If it does not confirm, then it sends connection refused message. Okay. Now, after the connection has been established, the data is sent using the data form message. We call it DT. When this DT uses the basic connection oriented service, then it is called DT1 or data form 1. When it uses flow control based connection class, then we call it data form 2. Okay. And finally, the release message and the virtual call has to be teared down, then the release message is sent, and in response to release, RLC is responded back saying that the connection release has been completed. Okay, these are the primitives used for establishing the virtual circuit and for releasing the virtual circuit. Let us see each and every message in detail. Okay, so the first step is setup. This is phase one. Okay, so to set up, the connection request is sent. So let's say A, B and C, these are the network elements. And A is the originator, B is the middle STP and C is the destination. A is the originator, C is the destination. Now A wants to send a lot of data to C, so it wants to establish a virtual path between A and C. So it sends the CR request, and CR request based on the GT translation rule, it goes to the B. Okay. B receives this CR request and it sends the CR request to C. After receiving the connection request from B, C sends the acknowledgement. If it has accepted the connection request, it will say connection confirmed from C to B, and the connection confirmed is further sent to A from B using connection confirmed message. And after this message has arrived at A, A is assured that there is a connection established between A and C via PPRT. Okay, so here every node has put some kind of local reference number corresponding to this virtual path, so that any further message that comes on this virtual path, it will be sent across using the same set of nodes to the next party. So that way the whole virtual path is honored. Okay, this is called virtual path, or you can call it a virtual circuit, or you can call it a session. Now another case is that if C rejects this connection request, then it is going to send the connection refused message and on receiving the connection refused message, B will also send the connection refused message. So this means that the virtual path is not established. Okay, so let us assume that the connection path has actually succeeded, and let us look at the phase 2, which is sending the actual data transfer. So for data transfer, just like for the connectionless protocol, the HTTP message used was UDT, that is unit data. For the connection oriented protocol, data form messages are used, and these data form messages, they are not acknowledged. Okay, so let's suppose again we have A, we have B and we have C. So the DT message from A to process goes to B, and then from B it goes to B. This DT1 message or 2 message, they are not acknowledged. All the flow control error messaging and everything it uses mainly for mainly of that of MTP2 layer. Okay, so there is no acknowledgement at the top layer. And there are basically two kinds of data transfer messages or data form messages. One is DT1 and another is DT2. This is based on the class of the message used. For DT1, it is just a basic connection oriented protocol, and for DT2 it means it is flow control. Now, being a virtual path or virtual circuit, one can be assured that all the messages will arrive in sequence. So there is practically no need for putting a sequence number, but for the purpose of flow control, whether the higher layers are receiving the messages directly and processing it timely, or they are not just dropping it, to provide that kind of flow control, one can have the sequence number and acknowledgement number. And if that particular class is used, this is called class 3 and DT1 is called class 2. So if you want flow control, then use class 3. If you don't want flow control, then use class 2. Okay. And after the data transfer, finally, the third part is the release. So what it means is when the virtual circuit has been used and there is no more data to be transferred, then A will send the release message, or even B can also send the release message. Okay, A will send the release message, B will send the release message to C, and after deleting the virtual circuit, C will send back the release confirmation and B will send the release confirmation to A. So this way, the virtual path which was established, all the references are deleted and the circuit closed. Okay, so that's all about the connection oriented message.